from Chicago, originally in the South Side. Before I got into comedy, I used to work on the docks, loading trucks, you know? It's one of these jobs where it's chic to have no teeth and smoke Camels. Everybody talked like this, "What's up? Not much, same old shit, what's up with you?" They weren't the brightest guys. One guy had a tattoo, "Born to load freight." He had a third grade education, but he had all the answers to the world's problems. You ever meet these people? They flunk out of kindergarten, but they know everything. He'd stand out in front of his truck all day. He wouldn't lift a box the whole day. He'd just stand out there all day and pontificate. "I'll tell you what's wrong with the Middle East, John. I'll tell you right now. Too many Arabs, you know? You got 17 different religious factions fighting over the same land. You're never going to have any peace over there. 17, think about it. The Druze, the Israelis, Shiites, Christians, Muslims, PLO, Qantas, Knights of Columbus, Shriners. You're never going to have any peace. I'll tell you what they should do. I'll tell you right now. All those different religions, they should just have one big softball tournament, you know? Double elimination, winner rules the country. Next year, you have another tournament. Keep it going each year, you know? New tournament, new leader. New tournament, new leader. Just keep it going, you know? We got our own problems in this country. We can't even sell our products overseas anymore. I'll tell you why we can't sell American products overseas. I'll tell you right now. People overseas don't want to buy a smokeless cigarette, or non-dairy creamer, or non-alcoholic beer. The hell's next? Chewless gum? Non-stick tape? Makes about as much sense as non-scent deodorant. Still haven't figured that one out yet. The reason you buy deodorant, you like the way you stink to begin with. What's the sense of buying unscented if you're gonna stink the same, you stupid sons of bitches? What a crock of shit. Oh, don't get me started. Now leave that box there, I'll set it up in a second. I'll tell you what's killing this country. I'll tell you right now. Junk mail. Every week, some goddamn charity sends me their junk mail. Save the trees, quit the logging. Save the trees, quit the logging. You want to save your trees? Quit sending me your goddamn junk mail, you stupid sons of bitches. What a crock of shit. Oh, don't get me started. Yeah, leave that box there. I'll set it up in a second. Damn snails, but following me around all day. Education system's killing this country. I'll tell you what's wrong with the education system. I'll tell you right now. Language barrier. One word, language barrier. How's a teacher gonna teach a kid fifth grade math when he doesn't understand first grade English? She spends half the time trying to break the language barrier than she does teaching the subject. The rest of the kids suffer. They gotta wait for Jose and Yoko to catch up. Hey, if we're gonna pay our taxes to put these kids through school, I don't care if they're 15 or 50, if they can't speak the language, they gotta go to the first grade. It's so simple. How the hell are they gonna get a job like mine if they don't go to school? Yeah, leave that box there, I'll set it up in a second. My grandfather was like that. Funny guy, but what a bigot. Oh man, this guy, we'd be driving in the car, he's like, "Come on, move that piece of shit, you know, good taco bending, tamale eating, green card carrying, guacamole shitting, Chevy driving, jobless son of a wetback bastard. I'm late for church." It's like, oh my God. I can't believe you just said that. Ignorance is bliss. The thing is, folks, we don't live that long to be consumed with racism and prejudice. We're not on Earth that long, man. We're here like this, and we're gone. You can't be preoccupied with that bullshit. You got to live the life for the moment. It can go like that. That's why you got to enjoy the moment. Do the things you like to do.